Hello and welcome. I'm Gargi Rawat. You're watching me on youtube.com/NDTV. This is the site to go to for all our shows and our videos. Well, every day we ask you what are the stories you want to know more about. And here you can see our top five stories of the day. And of course, everyone more concerned about the coronavirus pandemic. Over 10,000 global deaths have taken place. Italy, in fact, has crossed China with the maximum number of coronavirus-related deaths. There you can see that is our second story. Also today morning at 5:30, the four men who were convicted of raping Nirbhaya were hanged. That took place at 5:30 in the morning. In fact, just 2 hours before that, the Supreme Court denied their last plea. So they kept going to the courts for various pleas and petitions, and finally even their last plea was just denied a few hours before the hanging took place at 5:30. Will Kamal Nath's government survive? Well, now it's quite clear that it's not going to survive, and we're expecting Kamal Nath to announce his resignation in a short while from now. He will be addressing a press conference. The numbers just don't add up in his favor after 22 MLAs gave in their resignations. Janta curfew on Sunday over coronavirus, and this is something that the Prime Minister spoke about yesterday in his address to the nation on coronavirus. And he's asked that on Sunday, he's also asked for a lot of discipline, that all of us do as much as we can to isolate ourselves and ensure we don't go into crowded areas and expose ourselves and others to the virus. But he's also asked that on Sunday everybody observe a curfew between the morning till the evening, and he's asked everyone to stay indoors. It's a Sunday, so it shouldn't be too difficult, but perhaps it is a precursor to more restrictions to come. Already there are many restrictions, and restaurants and malls are closed, gyms and parlors, etc., are all closed down. Well, the big news of this morning was the Nirbhaya case, and the fact that after 7 years, her rapists were hanged. And of course, this has brought some amount of solace and peace to her parents, who we've seen all these last couple of weeks and months doing the rounds of the courts, very anguished over the delays that were taking place. And but that, of course, we have to understand is a process. It is in the Indian system, in our laws, that people who are sentenced to death have these certain avenues, have these petitions, that appeals that they can make, and that is something they are permitted to do. But yes, questions have been raised about the manner in which it was done. There were four convicts, and how each of them turn by turn it was exhausting their various petitions and pleas, mercy petitions before the president, and in a way, were they gaming the system? But many argue that this is something that they should be allowed to do. However, Nirbhaya's parents were saying that they'd like it if this whole process, there could be a timeline for it, that if your death sentence is confirmed by the Supreme Court, then there should be a timeline about for how long you can continue to seek these petitions and pleas in the courts and to the president. Let's just take a look at her first reaction. This is Asha Devi, Nirbhaya's mother.
ये आज 7 साल का संघर्ष था. ये पहली बार है जो चार मुजरिमों को फांसी पर लटकाया गया है. ये पहली बार है कि एक देश में बच्ची के साथ रेप बलात्कार हुआ था. आज पहली बार उसको इंसाफ मिला. आज का दिन 20 मार्च है. आज का दिन हमारी बच्चियों के नाम, हमारे महिलाओं के नाम, क्योंकि आज का दिन निर्भया को इंसाफ मिला, पूरे देश के बच्चियों को इंसाफ मिला. मैं सभी लोगों को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देती हूँ. खासकर अब देर से ही सही इंसाफ मिला. मैं अपने जुडिशरी को, अपने न्याय व्यवस्था को, अपने राष्ट्रपति महामहिम को, अपने सरकारों को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देती हूँ कि जिस तरह से निर्भया के केस में रिलेट एक्ट्रेस अपनाई गई, एक एक करके पटिशन डाली गई, लेकिन जिस तरह से पटिशन डाली गई उसी तरह से हमारी अदालतों ने सक्रिय होकर एक एक पटिशन को खारिज किया. फाइनली आज हम उस मुकाम पे पहुंचे, उनको फांसी दी गई, निर्भया को इंसाफ मिला. जिस तरह से 2012 में घटना हुई थी निर्भया के साथ, लोग शर्मसार हुए थे, हमारा देश शर्मसार हुआ था, लेकिन फाइनली देर से ही सही, लेकिन आज हमारी जुडिशरी ने इन चारों को फांसी देकर साबित की.
All right, so there that was the reaction from Nirbhaya's mother, who we've seen very anguished over the delays in the hanging. But again, that is something that all those convicted and those sentenced to death are permitted under the law. Now, as far as coronavirus goes, currently in the country there are 195 cases. Four deaths have taken place yesterday evening. A man died in Punjab, and that is the fourth death so far due to coronavirus. Yesterday the Prime Minister addressed the nation, and really to bring home this whole issue of the need for us to isolate ourselves and to limit social contact and social distancing, which has become the term for how you're supposed to behave in this time of the coronavirus pandemic. And he also spoke about what we've seen in other countries taking place, like what we've seen in Spain and Italy, and how suddenly the cases have gone up because in those initial weeks or days, they did not realize how quickly it would spread and how important it is to isolate yourselves and practice social distancing. So yes, the Prime Minister yesterday in his address spoke about all these issues. And I think, while in the media and many of us have been talking about coronavirus and what one needs to do and doesn't need to do, the importance of the Prime Minister's address was also that it was televised across the country on all channels. And then it really reaches the masses who perhaps, have not realized how what an enormous sort of challenge this is before us right now, because even now we've heard of cases of people running away from quarantines, or people who have been asked to self-isolate are caught on trains and handed over by other passengers. So these sort of instances are coming up more and more. So therefore the Prime Minister, when he spoke about it and spoke about what's happening in other countries and how this is a big challenge that we all need to meet together, that we may need to sacrifice, and he said, I just want some of your time over the next couple of weeks. So this Sunday will be this Janta curfew, where we will all, self-isolate ourselves and stay at our home and not go out, and also come out at 5 o'clock to appreciate doctors and with clapping or music or whatever it is. But it's basically perhaps many people are speculating a possible precursor to what might happen going forward. We may see a lockdown in some of our cities given the spread of coronavirus, which we're told right now is still in stage 2. That means it's not in the community. That's what stage 2 means, that right now we were able to trace where each of the cases came from, and it's usually connected to somebody who has traveled abroad. Now an example of how people are now becoming a little more aware and paranoid is this incident in Maharashtra and Kolhapur, where a man riding on a motorcycle was actually thrashed after he sneezed in public. And this was all caught on CCTV in this area, where this person sneezed and another biker then asked him to stop sneezing or at least cover his face when he sneezed, and then led to a heated exchange, and one man thrashed the other man. So it just goes to show how this sort of messaging that's taking place. We're seeing a lot of celebrities also messaging about it, about how you have to keep your hands washed, constantly wash your hands, and also practice these sort of etiquette, social etiquettes, to ensure that even if you do sneeze or cough, that people around you are not affected. And the other big story will be Kamal Nath will be holding a press conference in a short while from now, and we're expecting that he is going to resign as Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh. The Supreme Court has said that by today evening he should face a floor test. But however, given that the numbers just don't add up in his favour, sources have told NDTV in the Congress that Kamal Nath is going to announce his resignation during this press conference. Well, that's all the time I have for you. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.